1,500 people who are out of work were at Navy Pier today looking for a job. The Department of Streets and Sanitation is hiring 1,000 people for a summer cleanup program. Applications are being taken all week, and our Bob Petty has the story.
Within an hour or so after the Navy Pier gymnasium opened and the first of the applications were handed out, the long lines that were expected here had virtually disappeared. Men and women came to sign on with the City Department of Streets and Sanitation. Some of the applicants are in desperate need of work.
Work has got to be here in order to put food on the table. Simple as that.
I need this job real bad. Yeah, real bad.
How badly do you need this job?
I need this job bad to support my children.
What happens if you don't get it?
Then I'll still be drawing my unemployment.
But you would rather let the unemployment go?
Right, and work.
The city's Department of Streets and Sanitation has 1,000 jobs open. They're primarily looking for family people, people who have been out of work for at least 6 months or more.
They will be working in various locations throughout the city, cleaning streets, alleys, public ways, and also part of our rodent control.
The first of the applicants will go to work for the minimum wage starting July 1st. Their jobs will last for 12 weeks.
Face another term, Clarence. I just can't. I still want to quit.
Well, sugar, you're going to do what you're going to do. I mean, you want to teach someplace else? Do it.
No, I want to open my own school.
Open your own school?
Yes.
Think you worn out now?
That way, at least I'll be able to show some of the kids and give some of the kids in the neighborhood the education they deserve.
Yeah, sugar, but you'll be giving up one set of problems for a whole set of bigger ones.
Problems? There'll always be problems, Clarence. Going to school for some of these kids is a problem.
Yeah. So where are you going to have your school? I mean, how are you going to pay for it?
Please not try to stop me with details. I will find a place, and I'll find the money.
Sugar Pie, tell me something. Does the word impossible have any meaning to you at all?
No. I know you can find a lot better things to do with your arms and your legs. Go to class. Are you all right, sweetheart?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
All right. I'm not going back.
So what you're saying is that you're going to start the school?
We can do it, Clarence. I know we can. What's a school? A teacher and some books, right? And students, right? Books and desks and blackboards.
What about a classroom, Marva? Huh? What about a classroom?
We'll just move out some of the tenants upstairs, and those two back rooms, we'll break down the wall between them. A classroom is all we need.
Oh, babe, it's not that simple. Everything would have to be rewired, reframed, and if we move those tenants from upstairs, that'll just lower our income.
My retirement fund's almost 5,000, Clarence. I'll get donations. I'll write to big companies. I'll ask for desks, papers, whatever else we need.
All right, fine. What about students, Marvin? What about students, okay? Who's gonna donate them? Tell me that.
Hey, the neighborhood.
Marva, those people can't afford tuition.
Well, they pay parochial schools, and I know whatever they do, I can do better.
So what you're telling me is that you'll draw out your entire retirement?
Yes, I would. Please, Clarence.
It means that much to you, huh?
Yes.
Well, I guess you better get ready to turn in your keys then.
It's so pretty. His parents give him love and affection to keep him strong, moving in the right direction.
Hey, hey.
How did you do?
Do? Oh. Well, the retirement money will be gone before school opens.
Well, I'm glad I took that extra work from the hospital.
But we're going to need more than that to keep us on top. What about your letter writing campaign?
Well, 439, I've written every major corporation in Chicago.
Did you get any replies?
Well, one company sent us a check for $5. Another one sent us a bunch of old paper that they were going to throw away anyway.
Well, that's big of them.
Bigger than 437 others. Miss Jones, I'm Marva Collins.
What do you want?
I used to be a teacher at Martin School.
Has he been in some kind of trouble?
No. I'm starting a school, a place to teach children what they aren't getting from public schools.
Why Martin?
Well, teachers at that school think your son is not too bright. I think they're wrong. I think he's a real winner.
Then why can't he read or write?
Read and write? Who wants to?
Martin!
Well, Martin, you want to be a flyer, don't you, Peach? If you don't want to learn to read and write, the closest you'll ever get to the plane is looking up at it in the sky.
She is right, Martin. She's right about that. I don't know. The school has him in a learning disability class.
Has it helped him any?
No, I really can't say that it did. But okay. Ever since his father left, that boy's been like a six-pack of lightning.
Well, then give me a chance.
I don't have much money.
Well, pay what you can.
I do like what you say, but I don't know. Even if I did, you would have to get him there.
No. I think if Martin really wants to be a flyer, if he really wants to be a winner, he'll come by himself.
Okay.
How much money do we have left?
Well, buddy, after we pay for the books we ordered, about $40. How many students you got?
Counting our kids, Patty and Cindy, just 5.
Well, just so you know, if we're going to break even, about 2/3 of these desks here are going to have paying customers. Have to.
We'll make it, Clarence. I just know we will. Mrs. Collins? Yes, can I help you?
Hi, I'm Lila Bowler. Is this the school Mrs. Johnston's daughter Roxanne's gonna be going to?
Yes.
This is my daughter, Tina. She's 10. She's been going to the 5th grade over there at St. Mary's. Mm-hmm. But I'm hoping that you take her.
Okay.
They tell us that Tina can't even read. And they're gonna hold her back. When they told Tina that she was failing, it was like something went out of her. She doesn't even talk no more. She's always, when she does talk, she's always asking, Mommy, am I dumb? Am I retarded? She's so sad and so nervous. I took her to a psychiatrist and he said it was trauma from the school. It really messed her up. Here's $200. And when that's used up, please let me know.
Okay, no problem. How are you all doing this morning? I'm Mrs. Collins. Welcome to success. Success is the opposite of failure. It is from a language called Latin. It means to achieve, to get riches, fame, happiness. It means climbing the highest mountain on earth or seeing the pyramids. It means learning to fly, going to the moon. Handsome boys do not chew gum or become presidents of the United States. You children were born to win, and I'm going to show you how. Class will begin at 9, lunch 12:30. It would only last 20 minutes. You will come here clean and well-groomed. If you don't, there'll be plenty of soap and water right downstairs. There'll be no baby work, no C-spot run books, so you won't be bored, but it will be hard. You will read a difficult book twice a month. You will memorize a poem every week, and you will write a theme every single day. There'll be mathematics, vocabulary, history.
Say what? I ain't doing all that junk. Who needs it? I don't gotta learn nothing.
It's all right, Martin. If you do not wish to learn, if you do not want an education, all you have to look forward to in life is poverty and welfare. You see, children, the system has people conned. Welfare is just another word for slavery. For instance, did you ever know a child on welfare to go to Hawaii? To eat in fine restaurants, live in nice houses? That's the first thing I hope you learn. That there are no free rides, that you pay a price for everything. So if you want to live a decent life, you'll just have to work hard for it.
I ain't doing none of that stuff.
I am not doing any of that stuff, Martin. Any of that stuff. Say it.
Any of that stuff.
You have that right. It is a free country, Martin. Do not wish to learn. You have the right to fail. Now listen, I love you. I love you. You're a bright boy. You're a handsome boy. But you do not have the right to disturb the other children's right to learn. Now, if you wish to fail, you may do so quietly. Stop interrupting. And stop tapping that pencil. Pick it up. Pick it up. Thank you. All right, children, let's get to work. Reading is 1 month's time. In 1 month's time, you'll be able to read any word you can say. You will do it with a special word key. If you wanted to get into a house without a key, you would have to break the doors down or force your way in with a key. It's easier, right?
Right.
Right, Mrs. Collins?
Right, Mrs. Collins.
Very good. Cynthia, would you like to recite the alphabet for us?
I know some of them.
Come on, sweetheart, of course you do. Come on, give it a try.
A, B, C, D, E, J.
Let me see that pretty face. Let me see that pretty face. Come on.
Q.
Come on, sweetheart. Good try. Good try. Good try. All right. Tina, how much do you know?
Please, I can't.
Well, don't you look pretty this morning in your little green bows? Come on, how much do you know?
Please, I can't. I'd be too dumb.
I am, sweetheart. IB is idiomatic slang, and we never say can't, not in this school. So if I ever hear you talk like that again, it'll be 30 lashes with a wet noodle. Come on, darling, come on. Martin?
I know the alphabet.
All right, Martin, maybe Tina would like to write it instead. Would you like to write it, Tina, while Martin says it?
Yes.
All right, Martin, go ahead.
A, B, C.
Lower.
F, G, H.
Very good. Tina?
A,
A. Very good. Slower, Martin.
Hey, that's wrong.
Not wrong, Martin. We do not say wrong. That's very good, Tina. It's a good try. It's not quite right, but together we'll make it right. We'll proofread it. And children, when we make a mistake.
That's a job.
Martin, would you like for me to sit down and show you how well I can behave while you come up here and teach? When we make a mistake, children, we do not erase it because we'll only make the same mistake again. What we do is proofread it by putting a circle around it. Okay? That way we remember the letter and the sound. Very good, Tina. Look at that, a happy face. You've made me so happy. And you made me happy for just trying. You know something, Tina? You will never fail again. I promise you, because I won't let you.
Today has been great.
Smiling face, tell me I have something to tell you. You're gonna have to take some tests. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. And for some people who wonder whether or not you're learning anything here, I told those people they can't give a test hard enough nor big enough to show what you children have learned here, right?
Right, Mrs. Collins.
What's wrong, honey?
We got this letter from the safety inspector saying that they did a safety inspection and they found several violations.
Are you
kidding? It says right here, if you don't get them fixed, here, read it for yourself. If you don't get it fixed, you're gonna close the school down. And I'm sorry, baby, I'm sorry. We don't have any money left. You understand? We don't have no money. We have a bunch of turnoff notices, and I don't know what to do. You may just have to close the school.
Never.
What else can we do, Marva? What else can we do? We have no income coming in from the school.
I'll get a third job, and you get a third job.
Honey, no, that's not possible. That's just not possible.
Well, if you hold on, then maybe next year.
That's what I'm trying to tell you, Sugar. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Listen to what I'm telling you. If there's no income, if there's nothing coming in, there will be no next year. There just won't.
God, you know how much I love these children. You know how much I love teaching. Lord, I know that all greatness and all great ideas come from you. Everything seems to be getting in the way. Please don't let me lose this school. Please don't let me lose these children. I need a miracle from you, Lord. I need a miracle. There's nothing else I can do. I give it all to you. All I know is that I won't stop. You have not put it in me to quit, so I will not. I will fight until the last breath.
I shall not move.
Are reading your books? Yes.
Sorry to disturb you. Are you Mrs. Collins?
Yes, I am. And you are?
I'm a reporter from the Times. I received your letter a few weeks ago. Your kids, they actually don't want to leave. What's the secret?
Love, hard work, and a very strong pair of legs.
There must be more to it than that. There gotta be.
Why won't people just accept the fact that good old-fashioned teaching works? I mean, it works for poor kids, rich kids, black, white, purple, anything. It doesn't matter.
Well, is there some sort of program? Do you get federal money?
You know what? Come here a moment. Cynthia? Cynthia, darling?
Yes?
Give a man a fish and what?
He'll eat for a day.
Teach him to fish and?
He'll eat forever.
Who said that?
Marcus Aurelius.
You are just getting so smart. I'm gonna have to make you a teacher. I got your letter.
So you wanted to talk about it.
Mind if I sit down?
Suit yourself.
Thank you.
I guess you want to know why Cynthia won't be coming into your school no more.
Well, if there's a problem, let's work it out.
Cynthia really likes you. And I know that you've done wonders with her and I'm thankful. But, well, I think she should just go to a public school. Go to a good one. Get a new experience. And I know she did good when she was there before. It's not the money. It's like I said, I think she needs a change, that's all.
Does it have anything to do with me? Please, don't take her away from me.
You just keep right on pushing, don't you? Don't take her from me? Well, I've got a word for you. That child in there ain't yours. She's mine. And I don't want you to take her away from me. It's either you or that school. That's all she talks about. That's all she thinks about. It's not normal.
The way I see it, it's not those kids you care about, just that stuff that you're teaching them. You've pumped those little minds real speedy like. Do you care how fast you go? Ever stop and think that you might be going just too fast? That child in there, she don't want to play no more. She don't want to watch TV. All she want to do is read. Read and study. For them other parents that might be fine, but me, Miss Collins, I don't care if she can't speak no fancy languages. I don't care if she knows Shakespeare. No fancy words, no big books. It worked for me. I just want my girl to learn how to read and write and be happy and get along with people. And the way you push, it's like you're experimenting or something. Well, I've got a word for you.
In all due respect, Miss Banbauer, is it okay that I have Cynthia recite a poem that I taught her in school? You'll enjoy it, I'm sure.
Cynthia!
Yes, Mama?
Sweetheart, please recite the poem that you learned this week.
And you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs, so they're blaming it on you. If you could trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubt too. If you could wait without being tired of waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies or being hated. Don't give way to the hate. And yet, don't look too good nor talk too wise.
That was beautiful, Cynthia. What do you think, Miss Banbauer? Can she stay?
Just to the end of the year. Thank you and goodbye.
Why won't you consider getting federal money? Do you know how much you can do with federal money?
They've been pouring federal funds into this neighborhood for years. It hasn't changed. In my estimation, federal funds are not the solution. It's part of the disease.
And you're the antidote?
No, not me. But I'll tell you this, everything works when teaching works. It's as easy as that, and it's hard.
Your kids, they're so terrific. You must have handpicked them.
No, most of the children I never met until the first day. And of the 15, 13 were failing or were in learning disability classes. But why am I trying to convince you? Wait until the test scores comes back and then maybe you'll see for yourself.
I already know what their test scores are.
You do? How?
I'm a reporter. I have my way. How do you think your kids did?
I know my kids did well. They're really smart. Probably near the top of the city. No, in the upper middle? My kids couldn't have gotten bad scores. Did I work them too hard? Is something wrong with the scoring of the tests?
Nothing is wrong with the scoring of the tests. You know, your kids took one of the hardest tests in the country and certainly the highest in the state.
I know. But I failed them.
Mm-mm. No, you didn't. You see, I'm here because we discovered that your kids scored the highest in the state. We want to do an exclusive article on you and the kids. To put it point blank, you are simply the best. This article is going to go all over the country. You have so much money rolling in that you'll be sick and tired of counting it. Congratulations, you deserve it.
Children, the test scores are officially here. Everyone did well. We have the highest score in the state. And look, we're in the newspaper. Congratulations to us.
And all the students now. There's been so many things that's held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting our shit together, we're polishing up our act. And if you've ever been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore. Well,
don't you get nothing, nothing.
Stand in your way.
I want you to listen, listen.
Every word I say,
ain't no stopping us now.
We're rolling up.
Ain't no stopping us now.
We got the group.
Ain't no stopping us now.
We're rolling up.
I know.
Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed this InCarn Zoom live presentation of the Marva Collins story. And now,
unique approach. The severe discipline problems, I think I always think of a little story. It's like the little boy who'd been to 14 different schools. And the mother came to me in April, just begging and crying and pleading. We were here in the house at that time. My husband had been working on something upstairs, and he had left the hammer in the bathroom. The child picked up the hammer that day after one of the children in the classroom. So I looked directly in his eyes, very serious, and said, you know, the good Lord gave you your head because he thought you knew how to use it. I have a closet just filled with heads of little boys who didn't know how to use them. And I keep them until I find a little boy who really knows how to use them. Now, if I ever see you with that hammer after another child, I'm not going to move the hammer. I'm not going to put things away that you should not have. We use hammers to nail things with and not to attack people. I am going to knock that nice head off of your handsome shoulders, and you won't have to worry about the burden of carrying it around anymore. I'm not going to call your mother. You're here to stay. I love you, but I'm not going to have that. No more problems.